चलो ठीक है, देख लेते हैं। चलो ओके, नहीं होएगा प्रिंसिपल तो तू कर लेना फिर स्टार्ट अपना। ओके
हेलो जी सर, मैं सर अनम्यूट कर रहा हूँ आपका। हाँ जी, आ रही ऑप्शन उसकी ना। हाँ अनम्यूट कर देना सर। जी सर, ओके ओके। सर जो पार्टिसिपेंट जो स्क्रीन से शेयरिंग का है ना सर, वो मेरा एनेबल हो जाएगा एक्चुअली? जैसे वो अपनी मेन स्लाइड है और जो पार्टिसिपेंट के लिए इंस्ट्रक्शंस हैं, वो दो स्लाइड मेरे पास पड़ी हुई हैं। तो अगर मेरा एनेबल हो सकता है तो एक बार चेक करें आप।
वीडियो कर दूं तो वो दिखेगी क्या?
हेलो हेलो माइक का ऑब्जेक्ट तुम्हारा मजा
I hope you all are well and safe at your place. As we all know, world is facing COVID-19 pandemic, and amid this situation, our college has already taken initiative for online learning program. Before we start this event, I, Dr. Abhinay Thakur, organizing secretary of this webinar, on the behalf of PG Department of Zoology, DAV College, Jalandhar, welcome you all in this two-day event. It is an honor and privilege for me to welcome our respective principal, sir, Dr. S.K. Arora, who gave us their consent as well as their complete creative freedom and always been a guiding force for organizing such an event. My profound regards to Professor Mrs. Karuna Mittal, HOD Department of Zoology, for providing guidance and her ever encouraging help to organize such an event in the department. I also welcome our respective staff members without whom this event would not be possible. I would like to extend my cordial welcome to Professor Puneet Puri for his moral support and providing Zoom platform for this event. Now I am delighted to welcome all the distinguished participants from various institutions to be present in this webinar. And now this is time to introduce before you our resource person of the day, Dr. Ranjit Kumar, who gave his precious time to grace this occasion. Even though he need no introduction, I want to briefly introduce him. Friends, Dr. Ranjit Kumar has made a powerful contribution to the field of research and is working with Department of Animal Science, Central University, Himachal Pradesh. He worked as senior scientist at Mahavir Cancer Institute and Research Center, Patna, for last 12 years. He has done research on cancer, diabetes, and heavy metal detoxification. He has more than 100 research publications and also guided more than 100 PhD MSc students. He has attended various national and international conferences, and he is also active member and editor in various journals of repute. He also handled various major research projects. The list is long, but due to shortage of time, I have to stop here. So today we are privileged to have an opportunity to listen to him. And on the behalf of all the gathered here, I welcome you, sir, in this webinar.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Abhinav, for such a nice introduction. And good morning, everyone. I'm very much thankful to organizing committee to invite me to share my research work, which I have done on my cancer institute, where I have worked more than 12 years. I am very much thankful to Dr. S.K. Arora, sir, principal, PG College, DAV, Jalandhar. And I am also thankful to Professor Karuna Mittal, ma'am, who is convener of this webinar. And I'm thankful to Dr. Abhinav for inviting me for this webinar. So now I'm going to give my lecture on anti-cancerous effect of selected medicinal plant on ovarian cancer. So I have done on many more than 25 medicinal plants for searching anti-cancer effects, and in this presentation, I'm concentrating on four important medicinal plants for cancer. So there are many students from PG colleges, and that's why I want to elaborate few common aspects of cancer before my presentation. So cancer is what? The cancer is the cells which undergo rapid, abnormal, and uncontrolled divisions. And the neoplastic cells finally form tumor, and these are leading to different types of cancer. And basically, they are of two types. Whenever that dividing cells remain at particular in localized condition, they does not spread into their neighboring cells, then that condition is called benign cancer. And benign cancer is not having much more concern from health point of view. And second most is malignant cancer, which are very much dreaded, and they are carried by bloodstream to lymphocytic or direct invasion to different cells. And these metastatic tumors once grow at particular places and then spread to different organs of body, and then that is causing death in many individuals. So this cancer is a not simple disease, it is very complex disease. And up to date, all about 200 distinct types of cancers are there. And these can be grouped into four major groups. First is carcinoma, sarcoma, lymphoma, and leukemias. So carcinomas are tumor principally originated from epithelial cells, and they may be ectodermal or endodermal. And so all solid tumors in nerve tissues, tissues of body surfaces, or their attached gland, including cervix cancer, breast cancer, different types of skin cancer, brain carcinoma, all are belonging from this group. And it is responsible for 85 to 87% of all cancer reported till date. And these are diagrams which are showing how this carcinoma starts from inner connective tissue layers, and then that spread to muscular and outer layer when it will become malignant tumors. Second is sarcomas. These sarcomas are tumors of connective tissue, and the cells which are of mesodermal origin, and they are solid tumor growing in connective tissue, cartilage, bones, and muscles. Although they account for most of the cancer studied in laboratory animal. So whenever in our laboratory we are preparing any cancer model, so majority of these cancer models are belonging to sarcomas, and it contributes for 2 to 3% of all human cancer. Common sites are skull cancer, cancer in lips, long bones of lower limb, and long bones of upper limbs, pelvic region cancer. And third is lymphomas. So these are cancers in which there is excessive production of lymphocytes by the lymph nodes. For example, cancer from spleen, thymus, bone marrows, and many lymph nodes are belonging from the lymphoma category. And Hodgkin and non-Hodgkin lymphoma also constitute for the, and they constitute for about 5 to 6% of all human cancers. So leukemias are fourth most cancer type, and they are neoplastic growth in leukocytes, that means white blood cells. And they are characterized by excessive production of the cells, excessive production of white blood cells. And it constitutes about 4 to 5% of whole human cancers. And it is of four types. First is acute lymphoblastic leukemia, that is in short called ALL. And this ALL is generally reported in children. It grows very quickly and very much most common in infants to 10 years of age children. Second is acute myelogenous leukemia, that is called AML. It is found in myeloid cells. It also grows very quickly like ALL, and it is common in adult as well as children. And according to Globocon data 2010, 18,000 cases per year are reported by AML. Third most is chronic lymphoblastic leukemia, that is called CLL. It is found in lymphoid cells. It grows very slowly and it is more common in adult above 55 years of age, and yearly more than 1500 cases are reported from CLL as per Globocon data. Fourth type is chronic myelogenous leukemia, and it also grow very slowly and it is common in adult, and its prevalence rate are 6,000 cases per year in adults. So what are common causes of cancers? So common factors and cancer death are studied by many workers, and it is found that change in diet, fast food, all these things, they may account for 35% of cancer death. Tobacco, that accounts for 30% of cancer death according to different studies. Different infections of bacteria, virus and fungi, they account for 10% of cancer death. Alcohol consumption, they are generally responsible for GI tract cancer, and it is responsible for 3% of cancer death. Reproductive and sexual behavior and HRT, hormonal treatment, they are responsible for 7% of cancer death. Occupational exposure of different chemicals are responsible for 4% of cancer death. Pollution, different types of pollution may account for 2% of death. Geophysical factor for 3%. Medicines and medicinal product side effects and overuse are accounts for 1% of death. And industrial products are account for almost 1% of deaths, cancer deaths. So if we see data, we can see in US, cancer mortality accounts for second cause of death. First is heart disease, 28%. And second is cancer disease. That is 22.8% of people die after diagnosis of cancer. So that is very alarming figure for future. So these are diagrams showing incidence of different cancer by sites and death rate of overall cancer. And we can say that in male, majority of cancer incidents are from colon and rectum cancer, prostate cancer, lung cancer, leukemias, and urinary tract infection. While incidence of cancer are more in females, from lung cancer, 13%, breast cancer is very high, then colon and rectum cancer, ovary cancer is 4.2% only, and uterine is 8.2%. Well, when we see the death rate of these cancer, then we can see
I just want to interrupt you for 1 minute. Actually, Principal Sir has joined us right now.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Now, yes, sir has joined us. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, brother. Good morning.
Sir, I welcome you at this podium. And now I request you to please say a few words for our resource person.
The key resource person of this webinar, Dr. Ranjit Kumar Ji. और मेरे सभी ही जियोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट के मेरे कोलीग्स एंड डीए स्टूडेंट्स, सबसे पहले तो मैं बधाई देता हूँ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जियोलॉजी को कि उन्होंने आज हमारे साथ इतने अच्छे रिसोर्स पर्सन डॉक्टर रंजीत कुमार जी को इतने इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक के साथ एंटी कार्सिनोजेनिक प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सर्टन मेडिसिनल प्लांट्स जो है उनका आज इस सेमिनार का आयोजन किया गया है। मैं सभी को बधाई देता हूँ और मैं धन्यवाद भी देता हूँ डॉक्टर रंजीत कुमार जी का कि इतने इंफॉर्मेटिव टॉपिक्स के ऊपर जो है वो आज हम सबको एड्रेस कर रहे हैं। जैसा कि आप सभी जानते हैं कि आज के समय के अंदर जो कैंसर है ये बहुत ही लाइलाज बीमारी है। नो डाउट्स इसके बहुत सारे कैंसर के अभी इलाज तो है, लेकिन जो ट्रीटमेंट्स हम करते हैं, चाहे हम कीमोथेरेपी करते हैं या रेडियोथेरेपी करते हैं, तो उसके अंदर आदमी के जो है वो वैसे ही आधा रह जाता है, उसके इतने साइड इफेक्ट्स आते हैं। और अगर यही अगर उसकी हमें ट्रीटमेंट या एंटी कार्सिनोजेनिक प्रॉपर्टीज हमें अगर मेडिसिन और प्लांट से मिले तो मैं समझता हूँ इससे बढ़िया और कुछ नहीं हो सकता। आज की डेट में सबसे जो लाइलाज बीमारी है तो वो कैंसर है, तो उसके बीमारी के उस डिजीज के बारे में जो इतना अच्छा आज डॉक्टर साहब हम सबको एड्रेस कर रहे हैं, मैं सभी को थोड़ा सा डॉक्टर साहब के बारे में बताना चाहूँगा कि डॉक्टर रंजीत कुमार जी बहुत ही एक बढ़िया एजुकेशनिस्ट हैं। ही इज वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हैं वो सेंट्रल यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश के अंदर कार्यरत हैं। तो मैं इनका जो है बायोडाटा देख रहा था तो मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगा कि इतना अच्छा इनका रिसर्च वर्क है कि इन्होंने 2009 के अंदर जो है अपनी पीएचडी की और 102 रिसर्च पब्लिकेशंस हैं, उसके अंदर 33 नेशनल और 69 इंटरनेशनल पब्लिकेशंस हैं और 114 जो है इन्होंने रिसर्च स्टूडेंट्स को गाइड किया है, जिसके अंदर 12 पीएचडी स्टूडेंट्स भी हैं और ही हैज अटेंडेड अबाउट 63 कॉन्फ्रेंसेस आउट ऑफ विच 26 आर द इंटरनेशनल एंड 37 आर द नेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस। ही हैज एडिटेड 4 बुक्स, 1 इज इन इंडिया एंड 3 इन जर्मनी। तो बहुत सारी अचीवमेंट्स हैं, बहुत सारे फेलोशिप्स हैं, बहुत सारी इन्होंने बुक्स का या अलग अलग जो है हमारी रिसर्च जो होती हैं उनके अंदर ये लाइव मेंबर्स हैं और बहुत सारे अवार्ड्स जो हैं इन्होंने जीते हैं। इनको बेस्ट पोस्टर प्रेजेंटेशन अवार्ड जो है वो मिला है डिफरेंट जो है सेमिनार्स के अंदर और ही हैज हैंडल्ड मेजर रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स भी इन्होंने जो है वो DST गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया के एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड ब्रिटिश काउंसिल UK के कोलैबोरेशन के साथ इन्होंने जो है वो रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स किए हैं। और इससे भी बढ़िया बात है कि ही हैज वन पेटेंट ए मेथड एंड अपरेटस फॉर रिमूविंग आर्सेनिक फ्रॉम वाटर। तो ये वो फील्ड है जो हम सबको अफेक्ट करता है। तो हम ये सब जैसे आप अगर हम बात करें मालवा की तो हम सब कहते हैं कि मालवा के अंदर जो है वो कैंसर पेशेंट्स बहुत है, बहुत सारी रिसर्च हो रही है और उसके अंदर ये भी आया है कि एक कारण जो है वो यूरेनियम है और या उसके अंदर आर्सेनिक है। तो मैं समझता हूँ कि ये बहुत कॉमन सब्जेक्ट और उसके अंदर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, हर आदमी को जो है ये अच्छा लगेगा, इसकी इंफॉर्मेशन जो है सबको लगेगा कि कहीं ना कहीं उसकी नॉलेज में जो है वो बढ़ोतरी हो रही है। तो मैं इसके लिए हमारे सभी टीचर जियोलॉजी विभाग के और खास करके हमारे जो आज के रिसोर्स पर्सन है डॉक्टर रंजीत कुमार जी का बहुत बहुत अपनी ओर से और अपनी सारे फैकल्टी की ओर से उनका हार्दिक अभिनंदन भी करता हूँ और उनका आभार भी व्यक्त करता हूँ और क्षमा भी चाहता हूँ कि आपका जो है वो बीच में डॉक्टर साहब मैंने जो है आपका वो ब्रेक कर दी तो अच्छा तो नहीं लगता था, लेकिन मेरी एक और जो है आज यूनिवर्सिटी के साथ मीटिंग है, मुझे उसमें जाना है, तो सॉरी फॉर इंटरप्शन, सो प्लीज कैरी।
Thank you Thank very
sir.
much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you Thank very you much for sir. your kind words. Yeah, and yeah. now I hand over the proceeding of the webinar to Dr. Ranjit Kumar, sir.
Yeah. Dhanyavad, sir. Aapke aashirvachan mile. Thank you for that. And we are going to continue that. So we are talking on that there are high change incidence rate and mortality rate of cancer. As you see, for ovarian cancer, incidence rate are 4.2%, but almost more than 85% of cases are detected in third stage onward, and that's why mortality rate is very high of 5.3% of overall cancers. So that shows that in many cancer like gallbladder cancer, liver cancer, ovarian cancer, which are visceral in origin, have very high mortality rate because they are detected in very late stage. So these are common features of cancer cells. So everyone is from zoology department, and I'm not going in detail with that. Everyone is knowing that cancer cells are almost immortal due to very much regular divisions, and they does not follow rules of apoptosis. Loss of encouraged dependence are there, due to which they grow uncontrollably. Low serum requirement are there for cancer cell, and most important change is disorganization of cytoskeleton. What is cytoskeleton? These cytoskeleton provide safe to particular cells, and whenever any cells is undergone in regular divisions, uncontrolled regular division, their cytoskeletons are affected more, and these are that cytoskeleton which provide safe of particular cell. And you know very well that cancer cell does not having any definitive shape, so that's why there is disorganization of cytoskeleton. And there is also increased sugar transport or increased glycolysis rate for requiring extra energy need during cell division for cancer cells. So now we are coming on our topic, ovarian cancer. So ovarian cancer is leading cause of death among all gynecological cancer, because as you know, breast cancer and cervix cancer, they are detected in early stages, and their even survival rate are high in comparison to ovarian cancer. But ovarian cancer are detected very late, so that's why their death rate are very high. So women diagnosed with early stage disease have better prognosis, but early detection of ovarian cancer is not possible. Hence, it is leading to highest rate of mortality due to this disease. These are incidence rate of few cancers of my old institution where I have worked on cancer for many years, and cervix cancer account for 16%, but death rate is only 40% there. Breast cancer is 14%. Their death rate is also 40 to 45%. Head and neck cancer is 26%, but death rate is 30%. While in ovarian cancer, overall rates are 4%, but death rate is 85%. And gallbladder and liver cancer is 13%, and death rate are 65 to 70%. So we can see the incidence rate and death rate variation are very high in ovarian cancer patients. And these are very interesting slide which show male versus female cancer patients ratio at that hospital. And that is 44% male patients are there overall patient, and 56% are female patients. And these are numbers of cases which are treated every year at that cancer institute, and in last year 2019 we have treated 30,000 cancer patients, new cancer patients in our hospital. So these we have developed through our database of 152,000 patients. On the basis of that, we have developed cancer map for Bihar, and you can see very good that urban areas are very much prone to that cancer, including Patna, Bhojpur, Saran, Vaisali, Muzaffarpur. These are centralized areas which have been high incidence of overall cancer rates. While we go for ovarian cancer, the scenario is somehow changed. Patna, but there is addition of Bhagalpur, Muzaffarpur, and Baksar. So So this area in red, yellow, black zones are for highly prone for ovarian cancers. So there is urgent need of research on medicinal plants for economizing cancer care, because you know very well at present cancer treatment is very costly, and even low middle class patients are suffering from financial crisis whenever they go to cancer hospital. So there is an urgent need for research on medicinal chemistry for economizing that cancer treatment. So you know very well that India is very rich in medicinal resources and medicinal plants, and that's why India is also called botanical garden of medicinal plants. And active ingredients of many plants were used for their medicinal values. And since in present allopathic medicine, more than 85% drugs are derived from these medicinal plants. And we are using only 15 to 17% of synthetic drug till date. And curcuma longa, Withania somnifera, Imbilica officinalis, and Gingiber officinale has high antioxidant property and used in our traditional medicinal system long back. And they are very common medicinal plant, almost used in every household. Their active ingredient were used against different diseases since long time in traditional medicine, like wound healing, pain, and all these things, cough and cold for ginger. So there are lots of uses, health impacts of these plants we are knowing since many hundreds of years back. So these are very important golden triangle of medicine development. So you know that our traditional knowledge in which Ayurvedic medicine comes, having very important role in development of modern allopathic medicine as well as modern technology. With the use of these traditional Ayurvedic medicine, we are still deriving more than 85% of our drug as allopathic medicine, and we are working on many active ingredients and doing some conformational change in that through modern technology to get new drug for different diseases. So in this triangle, you can understand very well that as our allopathic and modern knowledge of medicine grew, and that is solely depend on traditional knowledge of Ayurvedic medicine and medicinal plants. So these are history of anti-cancer drug development, and it started from 1881 when a plant known as podophyllum. So there is a drug developed, podophyllotoxin. So that is ancient most cancer drug, and that is followed by 1958. There is vincristine and vinblastine we got from Catharinthus. And you are surprised to know that it developed in 1958, and still medical practitioner in cancer hospital are frequently using vincristine and vinblastine for different modalities of treatment. Then in 1959, there is further development, and we got eliptisine. And in 1960, we got very good cancer drug that is called paclitaxel. And now that is called paclitaxin. So that is got from Texas brevifolia. In 1966, we got new cancer drug, camphothecin, and that is originated from camphothecia. And in 1972, we got further improvement in cancer research through medicinal plant. And we got hemoherantinine. And in 1989, we got combustriatine, as well as in 80s, flavopiperidol. And that is, flavopiperidol is still semi-synthetic, having some conformational changes in that. And recent got in 1997, we got roscovitine from Raphanus sativus species. So working on medicinal plant for getting cancer drug is not a new practice. It is practiced since more than 150 years back. But still, there is lots of gap in this area to get a good cancer drug. So I have worked on four medicinal plants, in which first is turmeric. And I'm very much sure that every participants are knowing very well for turmeric. And we having a great traditional knowledge that it is used in wound healing, pain relief, and many gynecological problems, and a good antioxidants in our traditional medicine system. So it having many potent effects, like it is used in gastrointestinal cancers. It is also used in bladder, kidney, and prostate cancer. And in United States, they have developed a drug per 500, that is from curcumin. And that curcumin is active ingredient of curcuma longa, that means turmeric. And that constitute 1% part of turmeric. And in the US, that drug is frequently used as anti-cancer agent with the name of per 500. So these curcumin are used for brain tumor, breast cancer, gynecological cancer, melanoma, and bone cancer, and giving very good promising effect, but not 100% till that. Second is very known medicinal plant, almost everyone is knowing, is Vithania somnifera, that is commonly called ashwagandha. And this is Indian ginseng. It used to maintain positivity of state and mental and physical health, and it has very high antioxidant activity. And its root and flower, both are used as a very good medicinal plant, but I have worked on its root. And it having also many potent health effects. It increases brain antioxidant enzyme level, which inhibit oxidative stress induced in cell death. It also inhibits lipid peroxidation level, which provide nutrition in nerve cell and responsible for regeneration of nerve cell and synapses. It also increases transport of B-amyloid peptide from the brain to periphery. And it also downregulates nitric oxide production and decreases toxicity in body. So the third plant which I have used for that anti-cancer effect is Emblica officinalis, that is commonly known as amla. And this amla is also a very good medicinal plant used since many year long back in our traditional medicine system. It is very rich source in vitamin C as well as high antioxidant value. And health effect of Emblica officinalis includes, it protects cardiovascular diseases. It is also, it said, neuroprotective. It having very high antioxidant role. Few anti-cancer studies are also carried out on active ingredient of amla. It is antibacterial, anti-inflammatory, and immunomodulator medicinal plants. And it is used in wound healing and gastroprotective since our traditional medicine system. And this is the last medicinal plant we have used in our study, that is called gingiber officinale, and that is called ginger. And ginger is almost used in every household in India, and it having active ingredient like gingerinone and gingerone, sagols, gingerols, and they having high anti-cancer activities. So health effect of ginger include, it is antibacterial activity. It is also a very good effect against diabetes and maintains sugar level to greater extent. It is gastroprotective. Anti-tumor and anti-cancerous effects are also reported. This is neuroprotective, and inhibition of inflammatory activity are reported from gingiber officinale. So So these are common stages of cell growth, and there is one Indian origin scientist, Dr. Bharat Agrawal. He is working in US, and he have 300 patents on that curcumin. Only that curcumin derived from curcuma longa, and he have given a very good mechanism how that curcumin prevent tumorigenesis. So that prevent at all three stages. Stage first is when normal cell is transformed into tumor cell, and when normal cell is transformed into tumor cell, it require constitutive activation of transcription factor AP1 and NF-kappa-B, as well as activation of these suppression of tumor suppressor genes, and these are leading to from normal cell to tumor cell. But curcumin inhibit this gene activation to prevent transformation of normal cell to cancer cell. In second stage, when tumor cells are single cell are transformed into tumor cell, then there is have tendency to grow more and more, and that stage is called proliferation. And that proliferation are guided by overexpression of oncogenes, HER2 new receptor, growth factor EGF, PDGF, and FGF, growth factor receptor, survival factors, cyclin D1, and D5 receptors. So these all adds together, and whenever they are overexpressed, then there is a proliferation, and normal a single tumor cell grow into a big tumor. And then in third stage, tumor cell grow and finally invades into different organs, either through blood, either through lymph node or adjacent tissue. And that invasion are required by overexpression of matrix metalloproteases, cyclooxygenase 2 adhesion molecule, chemokine, and tumor necrosis factor. And when they are overexpressed, then there is change from proliferation to invasion, and that leading to metastatic cancer. And you can see very well that curcumin having inhibitory role on these all constitutive activation of transcription factor, overexpression of oncogenes, and overexpression of tumor necrosis factor. So it prevent tumorigenesis in these all ways. So objective of this present work is to illustrate anti-cancer effect of curcuma longa, Withania somnifera, Imbica officinalis, and Gingiber officinale on tumor marker calcium ion and subcellular parameters of ovarian cancer. So we have prepared cancer model in mice, not using any cell line. We have prepared by use of xenoestrogenic chemical. So there is a common pesticide called Indosulfan. Now that is banned in Bihar after our report to Chief Minister of Bihar, that is banned in complete state. So that is having high tendency for tumorigenesis. And you can show in the lower figure that it's showing beginning of tumor after Indosulfan treatment. 3 to 4 weeks of treatment, it shows some benign tumor. And after 12 weeks of treatment, we can get full-fledged tumors. You can see these are benign tumors of the adenocystic carcinoma of lower lingual regions. These are also, after 6 to 8 weeks of administration, we can see different benign tumors on adenocystic carcinoma on their dermal origins. And these are full-fledged tumor of mice which having ovarian cancer as well as breast carcinoma. This is metastatic cancer developed in mice after administration of that chemicals. So we work on that. So now you can see the full-grown ovarian cancers are there in left ovary of mice, and this is also a growing tumor in second figure in ovaries of mice. So So we have done melanoidihyde level for knowing lipid peroxidation level. So in control group, that is only 1.95 nanomole per dl. In ovarian cancer group, we got 96.8 nanomole per dl. And we have done two modules for treatment. Once we have administered these medicinal plants singly, and then in combination with different combination. So once we administer these plants alone, like ginger, imbalica, withania, and curcuma, we got very least restorative effect in withania, that is only 59 maximum restoration by single medicinal plant. But when we administer this in combination, we got very good results. Like you can see, whenever withania and curcuma are administered, synergistically administered, that MDA level will become 5.67 mg per dl, and that is in almost normal level. In withania and imbalica group, that is 22.4 mg per dl, and withania and ginger. So withania acts very well either with curcuma, imbalica, as well as ginger, but most promising effect we get from withania somnifera administration with curcuma longa, and that is almost in normal. In calcium ion level, calcium is very much overexpressed in all type of tumors. So in control group, that was 5.48 mg per dl. In ovarian cancer group, that is 13.97 milligram per deciliter. When we administered alone these medicinal plant, we can get very least restoration in curcuma alone, curcuma longa 9.87. But similar trend we get whenever we administer these into synergistically, then you can see that withania and curcuma show very good result, followed by withania and imbalica, and that is further followed by withania and ginger. So withania somnifera plus curcuma shows 5.69 mg per dl of calcium level after administration, and it is also in normal range. So CA125, what is CA125? CA125 is a common marker for ovarian cancer, and in any healthcare systems and hospital, that is called as a definitive marker. And that is a full form of that CA125 is cancer antigen 125, because that is a glycoprotein which having 125 kilo Dalton molecular weight. So that's why name is given CA125. And normal range of CA125 in any female is 1 to 35 IU per ml. Whenever they have any type of pelvic infection, then that increases up to 100 IU per ml. But in cancer cases, that is always above 500 to 1000 in range. So in our animal group, we find 4.82 IU per ml of CA125 level. And when in ovarian cancer, that is 749. When we administer these medicinal plant alone, then maximum restoration we can see in withania 736, followed by ginger 423 and curcuma 437 IU per ml. But when we administer these in synergistically, we got very good promising results. So that CA125 level in different groups of mice was 56 IU per ml, almost reaching to normal level after administration to withania and curcuma, and followed by withania and ginger 109, and control in all groups combination of withania somnifera. So now we can see, after biochemical estimation and tumor marker study, we go for histological analysis of these ovarian tissue, and you can see mature Graafian follicle there in figure just upside, left upside, that is control 1, and very well developed ova and mature graafian follicle, ovarian cortex are there in first and second photograph. But in lower two photograph, you can see there is formation of ascitic fluids as well as none of the grown graafian follicle or mature graafian follicle are observed. And these formation of ascitic fluid are clear cut markers of development of ovarian cancer in ovary whenever it is seen in ovarian cortex. Many clustered nuclei and degenerated cytoplasm are also observed in these cancer models. When we treated this with a different combination with medicinal plant like Imbilica plus ginger, we got GE means germinal epithelium. We got very least restoration in germinal epithelium, and GF means graafian follicle, that is also least restored. In the second combination, when we given Imbilica plus curcuma, there is also not very promising restoration. OVA is seen, OV means OVA, that is seen in restored condition, but not in almost normal condition. But in Vithania and curcuma, you can see very good developed mature graafian follicle in figure 2. And in figure 1, you can see different stages of development of graafian follicle, primary follicle, secondary and tertiary follicle. And mature graafian follicle are very good with well-defined ova in it. And ginger plus Vithania also showing fully grown ova, but mature graafian follicle and granulosa cells are showing few clustering there. So these are a scanning electron microscope. We have also done for our study, because from light microscope we can't say everything. So you can see in that figure 1 that there is, from a scanning electron microscope, we get outermost surface of all ovas if that is good or that having serration. So you can see in figure 1 and just below 2 that that is very smooth and very least sedation like normal. But in figure 3 and 4, you can see lots of ooze are developed there, and ovarian, that plasma membrane of that ova are finally lost their identity in cancer models. And when we treated this with Vithania plus curcuma, you can see the same smooth membrane of outer membrane of ova in figure 1. And Vithania plus ginger is also showing good restoration. And Imbilica plus ginger, you can see there are lots of sedation in outer membrane of ova. Now, after completing a scanning electron microscope study, because a scanning electron microscopy study will give idea about one cell surface. What happened inside cellular organelle, that is not clear. So that's why we go for transmission electron microscopy. And you can see very well-defined chromatin membrane as well as double membrane of nucleus with polyribosomes in this control group. And nucleopore complexes are also clear in these ovarian cells. In cancer model, you can see frequent changes like few chromatinization and degradation of double membrane of nucleus as well as polyribosomes. Polyribosomes are a definitive factor found in all types of tumor. So in that figure 2, so there is G. G means granules, and granules of polyribosome are scattered all around cytoplasmic material. And there is loss of nuclear identity because the nucleopore complex and double membrane nucleus are found ruptured at many places in a transmission electron microscope study of ovarian cancer cells. And it is very frequent finding. Ovarian cancer, it is showing cytoplasmic inclusion and nucleus. It is very rare event, but it is definitive symptoms of cancer. You can see inside the nucleus there is cytoplasmic inclusion, and as well as giant mitochondria are there in just left side of the nucleus, and giant mitochondria, polyribosomes, and cytoplasmic inclusions. These all are definitive markers in transmission electron microscope study, which shows that these are tumor cells. So these are supported by this study. So then you can see in Imbrica plus ginger group, there is hyperactivated endoplasmic reticulum network. ER network is very much hyperactivated. Double membrane of nucleus also attains good shape, and few ribosomes are there with lysosomal activities, and chromatin membranes are also restored. In curcuma plus Imbrica group, you see that nucleus attain their shape, but even there is existence of giant mitochondria, and these giant mitochondria shows still there is need of high ATP.
हेलो सर, एम आई ऑडिबल टू यू?
या अभी नहीं,
आई थिंक डॉक्टर संजीव कुमार वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग.
एक्चुअली ही म्यूटेड हिमसेल्फ.
ओके सर,
अब बोलो. तो
आज हां जी पुनीत, आवाज बिल्कुल बंद होगी
जी.
And just wait for 1 minute.
Is now it must be audible.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Your voice is audible.
Yes, Dr. Ranjit, can you hear me?
Sir, just wait for 1 minute. Let me connect with him. Dr. Ranjit, sir, kindly unmute yourself.
Yeah.
फोन पे लग अपना म्यूट करते हैं।
Yes, Dr. Saab, you can continue.
Yeah, there is some technical problem. Always that is disconnected.
Disconnected.
So, scanning electron microscope. Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Can I proceed?
Yes, sir.
So, scanning electron microscope, so well organized, 10 and transmission electron microscope. Effective restoration in subcellular structure including mitochondria, Golgi complex, endoplasmic reticulum, chromatin material and ribosomes. So it is concluded from a study that synergistic administration of Withania, Somnifera and Curcuma are very effective antidote against ovarian cancer and it maintains normal CA125 level. It also normalizes calcium level to normal one. It maintains lipid peroxidation to greater extent. It normalizes histological architecture of germinal epithelium and graphene, mature graphene follicle and ova in ovary. It maintains normal outer cell wall of ova through scanning electron microscope and it causes restoration in different subcellular structure very effectively. So this combination
सर खड़ी तो सर Please continue. Hello.
Then you probably control the NF kappa B content.
Sound problem.
Dr. Ranjit sir, am I audible to you?
Sir, kindly unmute. Dr. Ranjit, kindly unmute.
Actually, there is network problem at their part, so he is just trying to.
So, if any question, that is welcome.
Thank you so much, sir, for such a wonderful and informative presentation. I hope all have benefited from the today lecture, and I thank you once again. Now, dear participants, the webinar is open for discussion. If you have any query, you can ask and discuss with the sir.
Sir, there is a question from Dr. Manish Kumar. What is the treatment period for this animal model and is this treatment acute or chronic?
Yeah, that I have discussed in just a second of slide. That treatment period for this animal ovarian cancer model is 24 weeks and the treatment dose is also defined that is treated with Withania 200 mg and that curcuma 100 mg per kg body weight. So that depends on overall particular weight of that mice and then we calculate for that animal how much dose is given. But treatment period is 6 months.
Sir, there is another question from Dr. Manish Kumar that what is your opinion regarding the availability of bioavailability of these medicinal plants as there is a lot of literature highlighting low bioavailability.
But you know very well, like curcuma, bioavailability of curcuma is and that is not till in this experiment, I have not isolated particular active ingredient. So that is available everywhere, curcuma, even amla, even ginger, probably in every household that is available. But the main act you have seen in presentation is their combinations. When we are using in a particular combination, then their effects are very good. And whenever we have done this experiment in many combination, like 1:3, 1:4, then 1:1, in different dose period, we have first calculated their MPD, then LD50, then Loyal, and then finally decided dose for particular medicinal plant in synergism. Because what happens now, suppose that if a particular medicinal plant having less toxicity, but whenever we are using in synergy, then what happens? Their toxicity may increase or decrease. So that may also work out before deciding dose. But for bioavailability, these are very common medicinal plant, almost not medicinal plant. Haldi, like turmeric, used in every household every day. Like ginger, almost used in every household alternately. Amla, that is very common in every household. So these are, there is no question about more bioavailability of these. If I'm talking about any plant which are very high latitude origin and they are like African, then there is a genuine question for bioavailability.
Sir, there is another question, that how was these medicinal plants administered? Whether in the form of powder or they were sprayed or introduced as nanoparticles?
No. That is introduced in the form, at first they are processed in our lab and finally they are prepared with rotary evaporator, particular either if we want to use for aliquotic extract or aqueous extract accordingly that. And we are introducing animal with Gavage method. Gavage method is through mouth. Because we are giving those with particular body weight. So for a spraying and any other method, we can't perfectly administer those. So for that, we are administrating through a Gavage tube. That is called Gavage method of dose administration.
And sir, there is another question, that which are the actual active molecule ingredient forms and these plants which inhibit the cancer cell growth?
Like I have given you details about curcumin. So in curcuma longa, active ingredient are curcumin. And in Withania somniferia, there is Withaferrin. So literature suggests they are active for GI cancer and many cancer. But till date, lots of clinical trials are needed for that. Like that, we have just completed our preclinical trial for animal model, and we are also still waiting for the completion of clinical trials with our hospital.
Sir, there is another question from Dr. Manish Kumar, that he was asking about the bioavailability inside the body, not the availability.
Yeah. Bioavailability inside the body. So that is calculated through biodistribution of drug, and that is first part of drug development. Whenever we are trying to use any particular new drug, so at first we are testing that drug for particular models for which we are working. So suppose that if we are using mice and we are first time using Withania, then we want to see what is their bioavailability and what is their distribution rate in different organelles. So their active ingredient like curcumin and Withaferrin are almost, if we administered up to 100%, so their bioavailability is 30% for more than a month in their livers.
Sir, there is another question from Dr. Rakesh Rana, that if there is number of medicinal plants that are available in the nature, then why we are going towards synthetic medicines to treat diseases such as cancer?
So, because I have told you one slides of Dr. Bharat Agarwal, he having 300 patents on curcumin, and I'm very close to him, worked with him a lot. Then last year we having a meeting in Tennessee University, USA. and they clearly shows that medical and pharma company does not want that our medicinal plant part are explored. If we explore these things, these business are completely stopped. But these are, you know very well that in Ayurveda and in our ancient times, we have been lots of knowledge of medicinal and traditional medicine. And at that time, no advanced hospitals and all these things are there in whenever you are seeing in history, but we are treating lots of diseases. So that is finally grown of our traditional medicinal system. If that is grown, all treatment modality and disease management are very much economic, preventing growth of this field.
Yes, sir, there is another question also that can bioinformatics help in the study to minimize the laboratory work and to compare different anti-cancer molecules?
Yes, we agreed with that question, because whenever we are treating with very new molecules, suppose that many molecules are still not reported in our lab in very well manner. Many, even whenever you go for a high hills area in Srinagar or Chambal, then you feel that there are lots of traditional knowledge with traditional people, but we don't have. So if we want to explore their structures and all these things after GCMS, then bioinformatics is very much helpful for that.
Sir, there is another question that do these medicinal plant extract, they inhibit the angiogenesis?
Yeah, because if they are working well for cancer model, so they must inhibit angiogenesis. If angiogenesis and that are going, then cancer management is not possible.
Sir, another question is that can we use the mixture of juices of these plants, and if yes, in what proportion?
So if we can use any mixture of juice of these plants, what happens whenever you are using mixture of juice? Then what happens, lots of their ingredient are you are not using. In that conditions, we should work on it and find out their toxicity levels and then advise anything. Because medicinal chemistry, in medicinal chemistry field, there is very least toxicity. But still, we should be aware about any type of toxicity developed. And suppose that, for example, in turmeric, we have 32 active ingredients. And whenever we are using only 8, their nature has changed. For example, I am giving you one single example that in our traditional system, many one is telling whenever you having wound or pain or you having some slight accident like of thing, the our traditional always say, you take turmeric, one spoon of turmeric with one glass of milk, and that is well for your pain relief and all these things. So that really relieves it. But do you know when that turmeric is taken in aqueous form, like if we dissolve in water, that causes male infertility. And when we take that turmeric with milk, that boosts male fertility. Because depends on that, there are lots of polar and non-polar ingredients. And whenever we are taking turmeric with milk, non-polar ingredients are expressed well. And whenever we are taking that turmeric with only water as a vehicle, then polar ingredients are expressed well. So whenever polar ingredients are expressed, their nature of work are different in our for our health. And whenever non-polar are expressed, they exhibit different work. So we should be conscious about all these things. We does not take anything without any lab.
Sir, another question is that is there any kind of side effects when we use these drugs?
No, for medicinal plants, till date, there is no side effect. But you are surprised to know that every substance in nature having toxicity. Like we are taking one spoon of turmeric every day for whole family. But if we are using 200 grams of turmeric for whole family, that is toxic for whole family. So every substance is having toxicity, but only dose is difference between drug and poison.
Thank you, sir. Over to Dr. Abhinay, please.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have last question with me. Sir, can we use these medicinal plants as it is? Because I have seen in Vidhanya Somnifera, there are some fungal infections on the leaves also.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
We can use these plant as it is, and you can even heard whenever corona spread pandemic are there in India that we must develop our herd immunity. And Vithania like thing, which are having very high antioxidant activity, are immunobooster. So these type of plant, if we are taking in separate form, there is no concern. But sometimes
there is a chance of fungal infections on the leaves also.
No, but for Vithania, we are prescribing for their roots, because Vithania root, leaf, flower, all things are used. But in our work, we have seen that root is giving very much promising.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Now I request our HOD ma'am, Professor Mrs. Karuna Mittal, who is also convener of this webinar, to say kindly few words for our resource persons and kindly do vote of thanks. Madam Karuna, ma'am.
Thank you, respected principal sir. Today's guest, Dr. Rajiv Kumar, Dr. Ranjit Kumar, worthy colleagues and my dear students, a very good morning to all. It is my privilege at this occasion to extend a vote of thanks. I would like to pay my sincere gratitude to Dr. Ranjit Kumar, an eminent scientist at Central University of Himachal Pradesh, who agreed to our humble request to deliver such an informative and thought-provoking lecture on anti-carcinogenic herbs. I would like to pay my sincere gratitude to Principal Dr. S.K. Arora, who considered our request to organize the event and is always there by our side as a guiding torch. Sincere thanks are extended to Dr. Abhinay Thakur, who approached Dr. Ranjit Kumar so that we all could listen to the great scientist. I would like to thank Professor Puneet Puri for arranging this meeting, providing a platform, and all my colleagues for their support. I also appreciate the kind gesture and interest shown by our students who attended this talk and made this webinar successful. Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the nice words. I thank all the members for making this webinar successful. Last but not the least, I thank all the participants for joining us. Dear participants, you will get feedback pro forma on your provided email ID. After filling that, you will get e-certificate.
The feedback has already been shared with the participants. It's in the chat box and they can check, please.
Okay, sir.
Okay,
Dr. Abhinay.
Okay, Dr. Ranjit, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you,
and congratulations to you.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Puneet. Okay.